78 Sports TV here. Salute to the mighty LDBC. Y'all smash the like button, hit the subscribe, and turn on your notification bell so you'll be notified when I drop a new video. And if you're digging the video, go ahead and share this joint. I'm not just talking in the beginning of these videos just to be talking. Make sure you smash that like button, y'all. This is the easiest thing you're going to do all day. Now check it out, man. So, shout out to my brother Ticket TV. I saw his video on this. I had done another video on JJ Redick, but I decided not to upload that one because new information came out that I saw. My boy Tuval told me about it, and I watched it on Ticket page. Which, all right, so for those who don't know, JJ Redick, new head coach of Los Angeles Lakers, has been accused of calling people the N-word. A few black women say that JJ called them the N-word back in the day, right? And, you know, of course, primates didn't want to believe the sisters because y'all been programmed to hate your own women. So, of course, you don't believe them unless they was accusing some brother. You know, when they accusing some brother, here y'all go throwing on y'all capes. Captain Kirk, can you save me? Captain Kirk, I want to have your baby. Y'all just can't wait to be Mighty Mouse. Here I come to save the day. That a woman accused Diddy of something. Y'all doing 100 videos. Y'all all in the comment sections laughing. Let one of these girls accuse R. Kelly of something. Let them accuse Bill Cosby of something. It don't matter. Y'all all over it because you like that. It's fun to you, right? As soon as J.J. Redick get accused of something, well, why now? Why are they accusing him now? Now when he's on the top, he just got the Lakers job. And now they're attacking him. Oh, my God. Well, why now? Oh, y'all so logical when it comes to old J.J. All right, but anyway, so a white guy came out and he says, hey, a lot of y'all defending JJ. Y'all don't know JJ from back in days of Duke. He said, this ain't no surprise to me, these accusations. That's what he said. And now, Big Baby, who used to play for the Celtics, used to play with JJ Redick as well. He said JJ was known to use the N-word in the locker rooms. Now that's kind of odd. First of all, it's odd to me that didn't nobody slap him. That you dudes allowed this man to use the N-word in y'all presence, and so freely and so willy nilly, right? And I'm sure when he was around y'all, he was probably saying it in like, oh, I'm the cool dude, the cool white guy invited to the barbecue type of way. I'm sure y'all would let him say it that way, thinking it's cute. However, when he, out of anger, the girl said he called her that out of anger. So now, okay. So JJ came out and said the women was lying. There's no truth to it. I wonder if he's going to come out and say that there's no truth to what, I should turn right there. I wonder if he's going to come out and say that there's no truth to what, Big Baby is saying. You know what I mean? I wonder if the primates on YouTube is going to be out here still defending JJ. I know why y'all defending JJ, and I get it, right? You defended JJ Redick for two reasons. One, you scared of them people. That's just how y'all operate. Y'all scared of them people. Y'all talk a good game. You're so pro-black and all this stuff until it's time to show and prove and be consistent and live by a code. Then y'all start backtracking because you don't. This is why. Check this out. Because JJ is LeBron James' homie, and you know LeBron James is responsible for getting Darvin Ham fired and for this guy, you know that's true, right? I'm not making that up. That's not about hating on LeBron or anything. Yeah, I know that's true, right? So if we're being honest, you know LeBron James is responsible for getting Darvin Ham fired for JJ Redick. So if JJ Redick turned out to be a stone cold JJ Redick, then guess what? That's a reflection upon LeBron's decision making, and y'all don't want that, so therefore you're trying your best to defend JJ Redick, hoping that these things are not true. But I'm just telling y'all, don't jump in the way. Don't jump in. Listen, do not try to stop a train for JJ Redick. Don't do it, brothers. I'm telling y'all, don't do it. No matter what the outcome is, do not jump in front of that train for JJ Redick. Do not do it. Because it's more and more people coming out saying stuff about this dude. Let me turn right here. Y'all do not want to be looking foolish or looking like you want to, like you know what I'm saying? You don't want to be looking crazy out here, man. Don't do it. If LeBron messed up, he messed up. I'm sure LeBron didn't know JJ was running around here, you know, being JJ Redneck. I'm sure LeBron didn't know that. But y'all don't start jumping in front of them trains for him. Don't do that, man. Don't do it. We don't know what happened. That's right. We don't know what happened. These are allegations, sure. But they're allegations against Diddy, right? Besides, I told y'all anyway. Oh, Diddy was in trouble for hitting that girl, or not hitting the girl. I told you he was in trouble for the Cassie chick. Y'all didn't want to hear nothing I had to say. No, bro. The FBI after him, because, man, he been messing with T.D. Jakes. He got videos of him and Carl Winslow. Yeah, you ain't know that? Yeah, they got Diddy on. Man, Diddy trying to flee the country. He trying to flee the country. He got a drug mule. Y'all just say anything, no proof. Jaguar White said this. This person said that. Yeah, no proof needed when it's a brother being accused of something. No proof at all. Y'all don't need no proof. Y'all ready to spread gossip, slander a brother. As soon as one of these people get accused of anything, here y'all come putting y'all logical hats on. Ain't that something? Well, look, we don't know what happened. First of all, we have to handle this with kid gloves. We got to be careful here, you know? Y'all start talking different and everything. Well, you know, we got to see what's going on. Bro, if you don't get past this car, what are you doing? Forget that dude on the bike. Go. See what I'm saying? Yeah, get past him. What a weirdo on this bike. You're lucky this camera on. That's all I got to say about that. But anyway, yeah, y'all so logical when it comes. My God, lady, this lady can't drive. Oh, bat light. Go ahead. Y'all so logical when it comes to old JJ and helping him out and making sure he gets due process. Same thing y'all did with Josh Giddey. All the accusations against Josh Giddey. It's evidence. This dude was hanging around by this girl, school, high school. It's pictures of him with the girl. You know she underage. Nobody, oh man, no. I mean, she lied to him by her age. I mean, well, no, man. Let them do their investigation. I mean, we can't just jump out there and accuse them. Bro, I ain't never seen this many people defending these people. Brothers, too. I mean, y'all just, you don't want to hear nothing of it. I wish y'all gave all y'all people that same respect. The same respect y'all giving Josh Giddey and the benefit of the doubt y'all giving JJ Redick, I wish y'all gave that type of respect to the other brothers. I mean, to the brothers, you know what I'm saying? I wish. But y'all don't. You don't. You make excuses up. You make excuses. No, it's different, though. Because, see, you know, how's it different? No, man, see, I mean, I don't know, man. It's just different, though. It's just different. I know it's different. I know that white ice, it get mighty cold, don't it? Whole lot better than that black ice. I get it. You know what I'm saying? White toilet seats. Boy, white toilet seats just feel a little better than black toilet seats, don't they? Don't they? White bread always tastes better than wheat bread, didn't it? Mm-hmm. I know how it go. You know what I'm saying? Y'all ain't gonna admit it, but I know what y'all up to. Y'all some sneaky sellouts is what y'all up to. That's what y'all up to. But it's all good. I ain't gonna say too much on here. But you know, JJ Redick been doing a whole lot of stuff, man. It ain't been looking good for him. It ain't been looking good for old JJ. Whole lot of accusations out here in these streets for JJ. More and more people coming out. Now you know what's gonna happen next. Somebody gonna pull up some old stuff from him, and all y'all just defending him gonna be looking crazy. All right? And now this is what y'all do all the time though. You know what I'm saying? But I ain't gonna say too much. I'm just gonna wait, let all this play out, and I'll be here, and I'm gonna remember every last one of y'all. Just, why now? Why are they attacking him now? That goes for everybody. That goes for everybody. Everybody who gets, what, girls come out. This is commonplace. Girls come out all the time. But 30-year-old accusations against brothers. And y'all don't say nothing. Y'all be like, hey man, you never know. You wasn't there, man. I remember Michael Irvin got accused. of doing some wrongdoing to this chick in a hotel. The video come out, all he did was touch the girl elbow in the midst of a conversation with her. And there, and I had dudes in my chat, brothers in my chat saying, "Well, nah, man, you shouldn't put his hand on that girl's elbow. You can't be touching her person. That's her body. Her body is her body. You can't, I don't care if it's just her elbow. He had no right to put hands on her." Like, bro, are we serious, fam? This what you're doing? This man deserves to lose millions of dollars because in the midst of a conversation, he tapped the woman on the elbow. The same way any of us communicate when we're talking, we touch somebody on the shoulder, on the arm. Well, no, man, Michael Irvin should know better. You know what, bro? Forget it. J.J. Redick should know better. How about that? No, man, that's different. I know. It's stupid. Later for you, monkeys.